Hello and welcome to 10 Star Ground Coffee. A few minutes on ground engineering to enjoy it while having your coffee. Well, here we are, lost in the desert. But that gives me an opportunity to talk to you about the geotechnics of arid regions. What's the definition of arid? Arid means that evapotranspiration is more than precipitation. So the soil always has a moisture deficit. And that creates a lot of conditions quite unique to arid regions. That generates very high suctions in the soil, particularly in clays, in low permeability soils. So on the rare occasions where you do get rain in arid regions, with clays, even with quite low plasticity, you can get quite high swelling. So swelling is a big hazard in arid regions. Then, it tastes nice. And also you get quite high salt concentrations in the soil because of all the evaporation it leaves behind the salts. So you get a lot of cementation of soils in arid regions. And that cementation can be very variable. It's very sensitive to temperature, chemistry, and so on. So you can get some parts that are very well cemented like rock, other areas that are not cemented at all. And that presents its own hazard, that variability. And that cementation can also be metastable, and you can get collapsible soils. So when you might build something in an arid region, you suddenly get a lot of precipitation, and then you get a lot of collapsed settlements. That's another important hazard of arid regions. And of course, you get the aeolian erosion and transport that I'm experiencing at the moment. You haven't got much vegetation to bind the soil and prevent it being blown away by the wind. That creates features such as this magnificent sand dune here. So sand dunes are mobile structures, as you see as we speak here. We're on the leeward side of the dune, so the sand is blowing from the windward side and it's been deposited down here. So this slope here is at its angle of repose. Any disturbance and the sand falls down even further. Now there's a lot of these deserts near quite built up areas. Such as in the Middle East. You might think they've got all the sand and aggregate that they need from the desert, but desert sand is very rarely used in construction. So all this sand around here, but none of it really suitable for construction. That's a real shame. But why is that? Well, one reason is the very high alkali content in arid regions because of those salts, as I was talking about. But also here in the desert, the sand is very fine. Very small particle size because it's been transported by the wind. Quite uniform as well, all about the same size, so it doesn't pack down very well. And if you fill the aggregate, it doesn't have that rough feel that, that a sharp sand would have that you would use in construction. The particles are rounded and quite smooth. So for all those reasons, the strength of the sand is actually quite low and it wouldn't be a very good construction material. So a lot of places, even right next to deserts, are still importing their aggregates from abroad because they have no locally available aggregates. And that's actually a big problem in construction all around the world, is the increasing shortage of construction quality aggregates. And it's becoming a real problem for the industry. Aggregate is getting more and more expensive, and that's where Tensar GeoGrid can come in, because it allows you to improve lower quality aggregates or to use less of the high quality aggregates, thereby saving money, saving carbon, and so on. Okay, so from the desert, a quick overview of the geotechnics of arid environments. That's all for this episode of Tensar Ground Coffee. Thanks for watching and see you next time, hopefully. So what do you reckon, Brian? This way?